As we saw in one of our previous videos, movies hated by the critics and loved by the audience, critics are not always right, and they can always hate a movie which is considered great by the public. But it also goes the other way around. Normally, critics do hate more movies than they actually love. And there are times when they have liked a movie which the audience didn't even care about. And sometimes it's because of other reasons that are kind of shady. But most of the times, critics genuinely enjoy some really bad movies. So this is our list of top 10 movies hated by the audience but loved by the critics. We are going to use the same formula we used in the previous video, which is that we'll compare the critic ratings with the IMDb ratings of the movie. And some of you might really like the movies that are in this list, but we are considering the audience as a whole and not an individual's choice. So we are really sorry if your favorite movie makes it to the list. Now that we have that clear, let's get started. Number 10, Buddha Hoga Tera Baap. Now this movie is not completely crap. It's just a regular average masala movie with Amitabh as the leading action hero at the age of 69 who can bend bullets in the air. It's a completely normal thing that any 69-year-old can do, okay? And it was pretty clear that this movie was made just to capture the nostalgia of Amitabh Bachchan's angry young man days. But guess what? It didn't work out. And the movie was a flop. It earned only 15 crores out of its total 24 crore budget. While the movie has an IMDb rating of 5.6, there were critics out there that really liked this movie. One critic gave this movie a 3.5 rating, while three others gave it a 4 rating. 4. But the biggest bullshit was that one critic gave this movie 4.5 ka rating. Like what? I mean, you're giving a movie with a bullet bending scene 4.5 out of 5. How? Number 9, Mubarka. Again, not a complete deshdrohi, but this movie was just a plain comedy with nothing really to hit home about. Anil Kapoor doing his best to put some acting into the movie, which has a cast of Arjun Kapoor, Ileana DeCruz and Athiya Shetty. But again, this movie was a flop at the box office, earning only 54 crores, which is still a big surprise out of its total 65 crore budget. And it's simply because the comedy is old. It just doesn't feel like something that the new generation wants to watch, and which is why this movie has a 5.6 rating on IMDb. But somehow, the critics thought that this is the comedy movie of the year and gave it good ratings. I mean, 5 critics gave this movie 4 out of 5 stars. 5 critics! And one of them even compared this movie to Andaz Apna Apna. Like, what the f***? Well, there were 7 others who gave this movie 3 stars and 2 others with 3.5 stars. So many critics just liking this movie while the audience considered it average at best is shocking. Number 8, Bullet Raja. Easily one of the worst movies directed by Tigmanchu Dhulia, Bullet Raja again was a masala action thriller that didn't really bring anything new to the table with the same old story and the same old action. And which is why this movie has an IMDb rating of 5. And also was a flop at the box office, earning only 32 crores while the movie was made at a budget of 52 crores. While there were some sensible critics that gave this movie a below average rating like it deserved, there were still those who found this movie appealing, with 3 critics giving this movie a 4-star rating out of 5, saying it's basically Tigmanchu Dhulia's Dabang. 3 more critics gave this movie a 3.5-star rating and 2 others gave this movie a 3-star rating. All of this while the movie has 5-star rating on IMDb. Number 7, Noor. Probably one of the worst movies on this list, Noor was a story of a clumsy, confused journalist and how her life changes when she comes across a breaking news story. Now, this might sound good, but the whole movie looks unrealistic in a journalistic point of view, with many flaws including the script, the acting, the direction and Sonakshi Sinha. And so the movie has a well-deserved rating of 4 out of 10 on IMDb, and rightly so. It was a straight-up disaster at the box office, earning just 6 crores. But again, there were some critics that liked this shit show. 5 of those critics gave this movie a 3-star rating, which is actually pretty high for such a bad movie, while 3 others gave it a 3.5-star rating. And one guy even gave it a 4-star rating. I mean, we should just ban you from being a critic ever, man. But if 50,000 of you guys can like us, then I think one guy can like Noor, right? Number 6, Ek Ladki Ko Dekha Toh Aisa Laga. The most recent movie on this list, Ek Ladki Ko Dekha Toh Aisa Laga, had a good message and was made with good intentions. However, this movie of the first-time director Shelly Chopra lacked in quality. I mean, a lesbian love story for the first time in an Indian setting could have been epic. But this movie felt like the same tacky old love story and was quite boring to watch. Maybe that is why it was a flop at the box office, earning just 19 crores out of his total 35 crore wala budget. And its low IMDb rating of 5.5 is well deserved. And despite all of this, the critics loved this movie, with 3 critics giving it 4 stars and 3.5-star ratings by 3 other critics, while 3 stars by 2 other critics. This just shows having a good message doesn't just make your movie good for the audience. Number 5. Bodyguard. Probably the only movie on this list which was a blockbuster, Bodyguard earned twice its budget of 70 million. And that is all thanks to Bhaike fans. But because a movie is a big hit, it doesn't mean it's a good movie. And Bodyguard is one such example. It's a complete cringe fest throughout, with impossible stunt sequences, bad fat jokes, cringy dialogues and a slightly dumber version of the Kuch Kuch Hota Hai story. All of this shows up in its IMDb rating of 4.7. But out of the total 8 reviews we could find for this movie on the internet, more than half of them were positive. While one critic gave it a 3, which again is too much for such a shit movie, there were 3 critics that gave it 4 stars. While Taran Adarsh, the same guy who gave Dil Chahta Hai 2 stars, gave Bodyguard 4.5 stars out of 5. Best critique ever. Number 4. Ae Dil Hai Mushkil. Now we know that a lot of people like Ae Dil Hai Mushkil, but we personally don't like it as much and consider it to be too forward in the first half and then typical old and cliched in the second. I mean, it's a good movie until the cancer twist comes along and you're like, not this again, man. Why did this movie need cancer in the first place is beyond me. It could have just been a relatable movie about one-sided love and unrequited love. But instead, we get to see a superficial love story which seems more like a lust story. And maybe that is the reason this movie has a 5.8-star rating on IMDb. But the movie still had some saving grace as it made 229 crores worldwide with a budget of 98 crores and was declared a hit. Not only that, a number of critics liked this movie, with 4 critics giving this movie a 4-star rating, 8 others giving it 3.5-star rating and 4 others giving it 3-star rating. That's a lot of critics loving this film which was so polarizing for its fans. Number 3. Veere Di Wedding. Allegedly a movie about women empowerment, Veere Di Wedding is the exact opposite of it. According to this movie, just because a woman can drink, smoke and talk about sex, she's empowered. Believe it or not, women have been doing it for years now. And since when is women empowerment about doing what men can do? Not only did the movie suck with all of its emotional drama, the acting was horrible, apart from Swara Bhaskar who was good. And the direction was patchy as fuck. So it was no wonder that the movie was a flop at the box office and also has the worst rating on IMDb in this entire list, which is 3.1 out of 10. And there were still a bunch of critics out there who thought this movie was good, as 5 critics gave it 3.5 stars out of 5, 4 critics gave it 3 stars and 1 gave it a 4-star rating. I guess these people are just giving good ratings because it's a movie with a good message rather than actually watching the movie. Number 2. Prem Ratan Dhan Payo. A movie about kings and queens and royal families in the year of 2015? Only one man can come up with a story as backwards as that. And that is Booraj Barjatia. Yes, I said Booraj. Struggling to make a good relevant movie since Hum Aapke Hai Kaun, he has since made Hum Saath Saath Hai, Main Prem Ki Diwani Hoon and Vivaah, all of which were really out of touch with what real life actually is. And Prem Ratan Dhan Payo is also another typical 90s movie with a prince, a princess, a jealous brother and a double role. A movie like this has no place in 2015 and yet, here it is. And it turned out to be a hit as well, thanks to Bhaike following, again. Making a total of more than 200 crores at the box office, it still has only a 4.6 rating on IMDb. The critics, however, kinda liked it, with 9 critics giving this movie 3 stars, which again is a lot for such a shit movie. 2 critics gave this movie 3.5 stars and 2 others gave it 4 stars. But there was one who gave this movie 4.5 out of 5. And guess who it was? Yes, it was the best critique ever, yours truly, Taran Adarsh. Man, this guy really loves Salman Khan, doesn't he? Number 1. Finding Fanny. Starring Deepika Padukone and Arjun Kapoor, Finding Fanny had an interesting concept. But God, was it a snooze fest. The most entertaining part of the movie was the chemistry between Dimple Kapadia and Pankaj Kapoor and the damn cat that died. The story of Freddy looking for Fanny is convincingly put forward by Nasruddin Shah, but damn was it a stretched out boring ass movie. We know this isn't the worst movie on this list, but it's on top of the list because none of the critics hated this movie. The movie has a 5.8 rating on IMDb and was a flop at the box office, earning only 28 crores out of its 29 crore budget. But some amazing ass critics gave this movie stonking ratings. 9 critics gave this movie 4 stars, 11 critics gave this movie 3.5 stars, 6 critics gave this movie 3 star rating, and one guy gave it 4.5 ka rating. You understand why it was so easy to put this movie on number 1? See guys, if you're rating a movie good because of its content and because of its story, good, it was a good movie. But if you're rating a movie good only because of nostalgia and only because it has good actors, that's not a good thing. So this was our list for the top 10 movies hated by the audience but loved by the critics. Do let us know in the comments below what other videos we should make next. Thank you so much for supporting us guys. Follow our social media accounts to get to know us better. Like and share this video and subscribe to Brainwash for more videos like these.